Greetings of the day, folks. Today we are going to discuss about the main important causes of lactic acidosis. So we all know lactate is a byproduct of glucose. So when glucose undergoes glycolysis in order to end in a pyruvate, and pyruvate in presence of good oxygen and nutrients and coenzymes, it is converted to acetyl-CoA in the presence of pyruvate dehydrogenase, and acetyl-CoA enters into Krebs cycle along with oxaloacetate and forms citric acid, and in this mitochondria of a cell it is converted and most of it is extracted, and carbon dioxide of the carbohydrate chain is broken down to carbon dioxide, and also ATP and NADH2 are extracted, wherein the final energy is extracted into and converted into ATP in the electron transport chain. If the oxygen is not proper, then it is converted, the pyruvate is converted to lactate in the presence of lactate dehydrogenase. This is mainly seen in anaerobic pathway, and lactate can be utilized by heart and also brain, and 70% of lactate is eliminated in liver and 30% by kidneys. Okay, now lactate, see, there are, if you see here, there are some important regulatory pathways. If at all there is any defects or any deficiencies, this may lead to rise in lactate levels. Okay, these are the main steps where lactate might be, lactic acidosis might be seen due to deficiencies or like stimulation of these pathways. Green is a stimulation, red is inhibition. So when there is inhibition or there is a setback to these pathways, then lactic acidosis will be happening, will be occurring. So let's see. So lactate. So here, glucose is converted to pyruvate and near the glycolysis. So the drugs causing, or the drugs or any hormones or any chemicals causing the stimulation of glycolysis can yield more pyruvate. If the pyruvate dehydrogenase is saturated, then it might be converted to lactate. Okay, so we'll see the drugs, catecholamines, theophylline, and in presence of seizure, and sodium azide, and in presence of shock, and sepsis, cancer, and pheochromocytoma. In these conditions, glycolysis will be plethoric. And this may be leading to increased pyruvate levels, which will saturate the pyruvate dehydrogenase and which will yield more lactate. So in these conditions we will see lactic acidosis. The other conditions where we will see lactic acidosis are like, which inhibits the pyruvate dehydrogenase enzyme, which prevents this step. Okay, so if we have a thiamine deficiency, which is the coenzyme component of a pyruvate dehydrogenase, and also in case of salicylates and cyanide and metformin, see, metformin is an antidiabetic drug given, and it inhibits pyruvate dehydrogenase, which causes lactic acidosis. NRTIH, antiretroviral drug, propofol, commonly used sedative, then induction agents, and sodium azide. Sodium azide is also seen here. So sodium azide, it increases the glycolysis and also inhibits pyruvate. And sodium fluoroacetate and sodium nitroprusside and hypoxemia and anemia. So in all these conditions, pyruvate dehydrogenase will be inhibited. The other conditions where lactate elimination is inhibited, mainly seen in liver disease, acetaminophen toxicity or overdose, and NRTIs. NRTIs is also seen here. So NRTI inhibits pyruvate dehydrogenase, also inhibits the elimination. And then ricin, poisoning, valproate, and heparin. So in all these conditions, lactate elimination is inhibited. So this completes this video. I would like to credit this. This is a slide from University of Maryland Emergency Medicine course, which was a free webinar I have attended. So these are the slides which were available freely from their site. Thank you, Dr. Gordon, for this amazing lecture. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.